never getting older, older. We ain't ever getting older.
Kind of a New Year's Eve glam look. I'm not completely satisfied with this look, but there are some things that I do like about it. This was kind of like a spur of the moment kind of thing. I was not planning on filming any type of New Year's Eve look, but I had a couple people that were like, hey, you should do this. So I was like, I guess so, but I just didn't really put as much planning into the process of doing this as I probably should have. And I think that's why it didn't turn out quite how I wanted it to. So if you at least semi kind of, sort of, like what is on my face right now, just continue watching and let's hop into it.
Okay, to start off with, I'm going to be doing my brows with the Goof Proof Brow Pencil from Benefit. This is in the shade 2, I believe. And it's a little bit light for me, but I don't like my eyebrows super dark since my hair is like really blonde. So I normally just go with the 2. Bite that tattoo on your shoulder. Pull the sheets right off the corner of the mattress that you stole from your roommate back in Boulder. We ain't ever getting older, older.
We ain't ever getting. Next, I'm taking the Stay Don't Stray eyeshadow primer, also from Benefit, in the shade Light Medium. Now I'll be taking the Too Faced Bonder Eyes palette and in the shade Garter Belt to line my crease and the outer V of my eye. Now I'll be switching to a petite crease brush in that same Garter Belt shade, which is like, as you can see, a kind of grayish, like a darker gray. As good as the day I met you, I forget just why I loved you. Now I will be taking the shades French Tickler and Garter Belt on kind of a petite sort of pencil brush and just going over my V as well as my crease with that, just kind of darkening it up with that darker shade. Now I'm using an eyeshadow blending brush from e.l.f. just to kind of take that color upward onto my brow bone, as well as blend it with the color on my lid to give it a little bit more natural look. Then I will take a makeup wipe to just kind of clean that line up and make it look a little bit more crisp. And I'll be adding some darker color, the French Tickler color, just to darken that up and make it look like almost liner, because I will not be using liner in this look. So this is just to give it a little bit more dimension. And I pretty much repeat this process about 20 times just so that I can get it absolutely perfect. And now I'll be using the Shadow Insurance Glitter Glue by Too Faced and just putting that on my lid in preparation for the sparkles to come. And for that shimmer kind of glam look, I am going to be using the color Dust from the Naked 3 palette and just applying that with my finger on my lid. And now I will be using this utterly gorgeous eyelash color from Tarte that I just got for Christmas, and it's so beautiful, it's bedazzled, and I love it, and yes.
Next, for mascara, I will be using the Too Faced Size Queen Mascara, and I love this mascara. I just feel like it doesn't clump at all and just gives a very finished look. Another one of my favorite things that I got for Christmas is the Porefessional Primer by Benefit, and this is what I will be using. I'm just going in and applying that all over my face. That I know you can't afford. Bite that tattoo on your shoulder. Pull the sheets right off the corner. Now I am applying the Too Faced Born This Way foundation in the color Nude just all over my face. Oh, hey Maddie, what's up? Now I'll be using the F80 Flat Kabuki Brush by Sigma to blend out my foundation. We ain't ever getting older. Now I'm taking the double-ended concealer brush from Tarte to get in the places that my other brush could not. For concealer, I'll be using the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer, and I will be applying this on my chin, on my nose, on my forehead, under my eyes, around my nose, and around my mouth. So basically everywhere on my face. Just a heads up that I actually forgot to press play when I was contouring, so my contour was done off screen. If you would like to see how I do it though, it is featured on my last video. Now I will be using the Tardiest palette by Tarte, and I'll be going in with the color, or the shade 2, the correcting, and I will just be taking an e.l.f. foundation brush and applying that underneath my eye. After that, I will be taking the shade 1, the highlight, and applying that on my cheekbones as well as slightly under my eye, on my nose, and basically everywhere I concealed. For lower lashes, I will be using the Tarte Lights Camera Lashes Mascara. Oh no. Do you ever just, your makeup is going so good, and then, yep, right there. You can't even see it, but it's there. For falsies, I will be using the Tardiest Pro in the style Flirt. For highlight, I will be using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Sweets Glow Kit, and I'll be using the shade Sassy Grape. I cannot show you currently because there's like three of them that are cracked, but it is actually the purple one, which I didn't think I would like, but I think it works really well. It has kind of like an iridescent undertone. Doing just fine before I met you. I drank too much and that's an issue, but I'm okay. Hey, you tell your friends it was nice to meet them, but I hope I never see them again. As kind of a primer, I like to use the Too Faced Lip Injection Extreme, and I just apply this to my lips, and I normally wait about 10 minutes or so for it to fully activate. And while this is working, I am just going to set my brows with the Ulta, I'm not quite sure what it's called, it's the Ulta brow tint gels kind of thing. And I will be just taking off that lip injection and applying the LA Colors lip gloss in the shade Altered Beige. I think this matches really well with my top. I saw it and I haven't used it in forever, but I was like, this is gonna go perfect. So I slapped it on. And last but not least, I'll be using the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray.
here we have the finished product of my New Year's Eve glam look. Thank you guys so much for watching. I sincerely apologize for the kind of messiness of this video. I didn't exactly plan to do it, but I still hope you guys really enjoyed this. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel that I will link down below, and I will also list all the products that I use in the description. And thank you. Sid Rebel is out. I will see you next time. Bye.